time meeting might take a fair amount. Well, I'm not either. Okay, enter my class, enter my class. First one, I know the first, and it's called the reorder of July 1st. We have Mr. LaChance from Hello Tanner coming in at 7:15 to discuss the task order with us. And anything else down there, general information down on the slide order folder. The next item of business, the approval of minutes of June 24th. I would suggest you table that. I'm sorry, I'm not sure, but there are a number of edits that need correction that you can make. We have a fill-in person last week, and some formatting issues and things like that.
Did you send it out?
Well, then there's another reason to table it. If you haven't seen it, we're gonna table it.
I'm really not sure what they did, or not. I know they just sent it to me.
Maybe just let me then, because...
Did you see that?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, so they must have got that.
Okay, table it. Community input. I will take the community input, and thank you all for a very lovely pre-meeting party. It was very kind of you, and it's very much appreciated. I'm not saying anymore, because I am not going to... I already started to, I'm not going to... I, we're waiting for Karen, by the way, so we ran some errands today, and it was getting late, we were gonna come down here. Kate said, "Oh, I'm gonna order Chinese food from South Florida, just one of them grab." So as I'm standing there, watching this boy, young boy, pack up our order, I started tearing up, so I realized I watched this kid grow up. He was a tiny little kid, and now he's in high school, maybe going to college, I don't know. Like the last time I was seeing this kid. He doesn't care, but you know, maybe a joke, so anyway. So I'm not doing that anymore today. So department business, the chief had to go out of town on business, personal business, moving back. We won't be able to see him. We still have a target range on the agenda. Well, there wasn't any, I want left on case either of you wanted any action taken, or if you're fine with the explanation that you received last week, then we can remove it. But we had a complaint, a couple of complaints from the president, so I thought we'd do it on. If you're satisfied with the, what was explained to you, I'm just happy to take it off.
I feel like we got explanations that probably explain the majority of the noise. I just like to keep sort of an eye on how often this is introduced, how...
You want to stay on the place?
No. We can take it off. The two things, just to keep in mind that...
Fire pond, as this is, the chief wasn't coming back, so he had to go planning on coming back. And fire pond drawn placeholder, he's getting prices for you all to work on, work out the budget process. Whether it's a certain level of expense, it's something that can be handled with the budget. So you want to leave it on, you can take it off if you want, I've gone to the couple of just keep it on the schedule. So now we'll table that. Highway transfer station. There isn't anything on here, right, except for the ETA task order that I can't wait until you have vacation, right?
What point do you have to pick up today?
I don't want to, you don't have to. I'm under order. You're on vacation, I don't want to.
I have to.
Okay.
I'd like to propose that from that chief that I want, because we have plenty of work to do. They got a roll money. We have the money in the bank.
How long are you?
I only got another week, the rest of the week. We'd like to finish that whole mill, and then if you've got time, we'd like to start something other than the slide location, we can still, so we have water.
So I know there was an issue with only one person operating it.
issue, and I wasn't aware there was an issue with it, until I got an email last couple days.
Okay.
I mean, most properties, property law, it's not always something, the location there might have been a poor choice.
Okay.
But that she should be able to, I mean, visibility and action is fine, it's just, he was in the belly, you know, like this, so.
The truck.
There was only a flag on it. Yeah, she was not taking one of them, it's a very small machine, so.
But so.
I mean, if you want two people all the time, that's fine, make sure there's, you know, somebody there, somebody better go down below, but at least go operate the machine sometimes too.
That part I understand, I think it was, the concern was that people trying to get around the vehicle, right, they couldn't see, so. Yeah, oh, you saw, okay, I'm sorry. Like, you like, you saw.
It was, you know, it's that corner.
Yeah, down the hill.
It was just goes around the grid.
That was probably not a good choice to do that section when people alone. As far as operating the machine, there should be no reason why, you know, why don't they just drop this, just, you know, as long as it isn't proper location, it's both of those sides.
So, what are your thoughts on extending the rental? It's not gonna interfere with you being on vacation, so it's gonna be set up on the weekend.
I'm gonna be, I'm off vacation the end of the week, so.
No.
I'm gonna go rest in that, it's just, the machine has to go back on the 6th.
How much does it cost?
$2,300.
And where are we gonna take it from?
We still got plenty of road money that we have, you know, we're not gonna run over this road. I mean, we got road work that needs to be done, and it's a lot less to use that machine, get things done, than we just try to do it back. It's a lot less expensive. I mean, that machine, go back over the ditch where you can be 3 feet, you're gonna set up, move ahead, you know. Yeah, you just walk in the other side and go, keep going, you know, just. I mean, we don't have to, we put it on the roof, and that is.
I know there's no, I know there's no shortage of amount of ditch work that you can done in this town, so I'm.
Yeah, no, if we can get a jump on some of this other stuff and try to get some of the water control that one down, and probably there's only like, oh. No, I mean, some of these dislikes, the water's running down the road, and the road's leaking.
Yeah, we have other streets with it.
We're going on Old Mill right now, we have, you know, we're trying to get some stuff to get away from.
We get that resolved, we'll be able to find.
The highway department is fully aware of it, and they have the contact information.
Okay.
Are we gonna be informed of it? I don't know, I mean, have you told me anything?
It was in an email that a woman, who lives, yes, on that street, was having concerns about the ditch work that had already been done. There is water getting diverted onto her property, already, and she had concerns, I believe, about whether or not the ditch work would remediate that or not, and how far down the road it's gonna go, and also, she was having concerns about, the perception that the ditch work was narrowing the road, because with the vegetation the way it was, right up close to the road, it just sort of felt like the road was wider than it was. They're not ditching into the actual paved roadway, so it's not really getting any narrower, but she felt as though it was, not safe to have the steep incline of the ditch work that they're doing. They're gonna shoulder it. It should be fine, it's just about a conversation.
This isn't the original complaint there, this is somebody else.
This is different.
Okay.
And I'm not sure I'd call it a complaint so much as a concern and trying to understand what the plan is.
Well, George, the way I got to this, if Ed had a contact information for the person.
I have the contact information, but I think it's gonna actually talk to her.
I'm gonna take her when I get back.
Yeah, but I'm not doing more on that section of the room, I'm not by, call my company, not even washout up here, trying to get that square one open. But, that's another ditch line that wasn't there, but, of course, I was trying to, they, and we brought it. So we tried to put the ditch line back, yeah, the way the road is, I had to be a little more, so the water was staying in ditch instead of going on the property, so. It looks, actually, the road, but it was growing over the hot top, so we actually widened it this way.
Yeah, the vegetation, I
that was just, we got other things we gotta do, so I figured, while we have a machine, we can keep it another month. If we can't, that's why we, I mean, we just, we'll put off and work on it. You know, we're still gonna, when they're done paying, they'll be able to touch up some of the shoulders down there, and we'll do it, so.
Is Mike over right now?
No, waiting on the paper.
Oh, you can't do ditch work without the paper?
What we gotta do is wait for, the grade to get where we were, so we start putting in, bringing the ditch up the way it should be.
All the rain, I'm sure, put the car behind it, so.
Rain, and now, we're supposed to be on it, thanks. But that road's a good road, even if the grade's in paint, it's not like they're taking us off the high top, you know, so they said that, that road's gold for them, but if they got to drop it, slide it in, get it out, we'll do it maybe, so.
We have enough rain. We have enough rain.
It's packing it in, the boys are not paying, the boys are gonna get back in, they gotta be ready to put it in, so it's gonna help.
All right, so, you're
Am I gonna extend the PO, or you want another PO?
I think another PO. But it's gonna be double the money on the original PO.
It's not about, he can revise the PO.
Or he can do a new PO.
Or he can do a new PO, either of the two. But if the board approves of the idea, you can also delegate one of you to sign a new purchase order.
I have one.
You have it all done up?
Well, I can go pay it.
Yeah. Yeah, why don't we just delegate one of us to sign it after we don't have to work tonight?
Well, I'm not gonna volunteer, I'm not gonna sign it.
One of us can sign it once you get it.
I'm not resigning, I'm gonna have a project, so I'm still gonna be living there. So, one of us can come and sign it. But in concept, we're fine, we'll do a motion to something to amend that.
My only kind of sign is safety is always the first priority, I'm gonna have to say, because it goes wrong way better.
Yeah, we're working on number three, just 1623. So I'll move purchase order 1623, Ambrose, to the Amherst equipment.
Ambrose.
Ambrose, sorry, I didn't hear.
Yeah, okay.
For $2,300 for rental of the excavator.
No, that's not.
I'll second that.
Okay, so move to second, the purchase order number, 1623. So move to second, and all of them say aye.
Aye.
Aye opposed. You've got your excavator for another month. All right, so we can discuss cricket landing, well, they can discuss cricket landing, can you go first?
Yes.
So we're gonna table both of those. Aaron, how are you? Do you wanna come on up? You don't have to sit right there, you're gonna sit near them if you want, whatever you wanna do. It's kinda strange to be down here. You can come right up to the table if you want, if you're not in the show.
No, not the table, really.
All right.
I'm just gonna give you an update on the truck.
Oh, sorry, okay, go ahead.
We found out last week that the one truck, again, we were told the truck was a little bit. The new salesman that we have has not been too cooperative with us. It's our salesman left the company, and we still have Eastern Fairfield. Everything's still on.
They have businesses in Hopkinton?
It's Hopkinton. Of course, so they use that excuse, we've been moving and all this, and they were not scheduled to be on the schedule until September, and I told them that's what I said.
Right.
I says, get the body here, get it done, so I might send to another division, I says, it doesn't matter. You guys wanna haul it any way you want, it's gonna be a job to us.
Right.
We're supposed to be here the end of the year.
Yeah.
So, I talked to the company that made the body, they were there after shift at Open House last week, so they just wanted to send me an email, but I'll find out when we end. We had a great issue with, so.
Okay. Once it's built and delivered, how long will it take those in the service?
Kind of, be ready to go.
All the others.
Oh, I think I'll do the lettering.
The lettering is probably one ring, that's the big one, you know, but, all the plow equipment will be on.
It's already on this one.
It'll be good to go when it's delivered. questions for George about the truck? All right, so we're good now, everything?
All right, that was lovely, great decision.
You're good.
All right, I'm gonna send you.
Good, just thank you for all you've done. Appreciate it. We should go out and see the whole thing.
All right. I didn't try to remember, we wanna go to the task order, right?
Yes. The task order permitting assistance on Sligo.
Yes.
And came to board 6 weeks ago, maybe?
Yeah.
We talked some order management costs, this is a little bit higher, and I wanted to come and explain why it's a little bit higher, if you have any questions.
Yep.
So I coordinated internally with our permitting folks before I came to meet, and said, you know, what order management would you be looking at for a minor permit? And there's a few things that, I guess, miscommunication between myself and our permitting folks. They were related to the fact that we typically do them a project where we have a plan, and we design it, and I say, okay, what's it gonna cost to permit this? So this is a little atypical, and that we're gonna just kind of do it, right? So we don't have a plan. We also don't have the wetlands flag, so I thought my wetlands scientist about it, flag this. I thought we did flag it for our last Sligo project, but we didn't, because what we did was we actually avoided the need for a permit, so we actually did flag it, so that was possible.
Good for them.
So it's not astronomically higher, but it's higher, so I wanted to come to the board and discuss it and see if they have questions.
So what's that for, that? $8,368 for the permit fee?
Yeah, that's an offset limit, you know, try to figure out anything that might be involved, it'll be less. Hopefully it's not more, but if there's some sort of issue raised, we'll talk about it, see what we can do. For our property. George and I talked, hopefully he has exercised some rational judgment in this, I think this project, the change we intend for the crossing, it's reconstructing the head wall, doing some ditch work. But because we're in the shoreline zone, we're all the top of the bank, all this other kitchen work that you're doing in town, it's okay that this needs a permit because the crossing is in culture.
Well, I mean, $8,300 is still an act of a lot cheaper than that. What it would cost to replace the culprits, so, or to put a brick in it, like reconstruct it all.
Where's the money coming from?
That might have to go. Where's your money? Culprit fund?
It can come from the culprit fund, that's the obvious answer.
Right.
There's probably some room, there's room elsewhere, I would like to.
Well, somebody built it, built it.
So I was gonna suggest, since we're finalizing Q2 financials, and let's just, sorry, we agree next week about where the money's coming from.
You can regroup next week.
But I'm sure we can find the money, I don't think that's really the issue, I think it's just where we overall.
The project needs to be done.
Right.
It's been something that. Long time coming. The project that we've been concerned, so this is a heck of a lot cheaper during good interest than what I first saw 26 years ago when I sat down. That's going to be like $125,000. That was half of it. We were a lot more money.
Well, so this is for Boyle's Manor and for permitting.
I understand.
And then.
I understand. In the long term, it's still.
Yes.
I'll leave it to you guys to figure out the rest of it.
So, the project description talks about stabilization and head walls, but we had emailed about guardrails. So guardrails, I would think, are like just incidental at this point,
yeah,
not really, you know.
Yeah, this is just our contract. It doesn't add any more effort for us to say that we're including guardrails. Well, obviously, the permit applications, we're going to talk here, and if you want to do that corridor and get that open permit.
Do the guardrails affect the permit though? I mean,
sometimes it's amazing. Think you get, you know, as a community, you go and solve the guardrail and the roadway on that issue, but we definitely have not some durable the project on the across Palm Creek.
Yeah.
Guardrail is the most difficult part of the project.
Really?
It was very challenging. They
keep card out.
Exactly. It's in the best of the situation. Yeah, that was because typically the guardrail posts are set off the edge of pavement. In this case, the top of the bend is very high, and the guardrail posts were, you know, they call it tidal buffer zone, so they don't quite have that situation, but guardrail can be tricky because of where it is in the roadway. I think you're the sole survivor, not that. You could probably come in and do a guardrail project, maybe on your own without being any permit, but it's really been a lot of improvements and repairs that gets far enough down the bank this permit.
Do you folks have any more questions for Aaron? I don't want to keep you any longer than you want.
If there's other questions, just Aaron, you should email them.
If you ask what you need, then. Sorry.
That was a big part of it.
Okay.
Good.
All right, well, thank you.
Good.
They're going to hunt until next week.
All right.
I'll get back to you.
Okay, so we'll see you in the future, less comments than you, so.
Good to see you. Take care.
Yes.
Has worked, thanks. All righty, so. Town administration, space, you guys want anything, you got anything else? I appreciate it, thank you guys for coming, and thank you for all the work. Appreciate it, very much working with you, thank you. Space needs committee update, shared facility director, and police consultant. Well, I was having a shared facility, I saw an email from Mr. Fulton, right? Or have you explained what Mr. Fulton?
So, yes, he has come in, and we started to talk, Mr. Fulton, Mr. Fulton and I, about what we know about the building, where the very beginning stages of that. He came back separately to put the boiler, and he's coming back tomorrow morning to see whatever documents that I should pull out right after that, maybe to see the contextual information, but the short answer is that he's advising that he not replace the building that we have. Until we look more into what his maintenance schedule is, what does he have for maintenance, but it's a good boiler, and those things can last a long time, and he thinks...
Or I can add more.
He thinks you could get a good five... So here's the thing, he's saying 5 to 10 more years on it, but something to keep in mind with everything he says is that he could make that happen. You know, because he did that with the school, and you and I were on the school board, they said the boiler's going to go any day now, and that boiler's still there. And that's because of what he's doing for maintenance there. You know, we're talking to him conceptually, but we don't have him actually doing maintenance.
Right.
So, you know, we do have talented for that. So, you know.
So you're going to pull the maintenance records for him to take a look at and see what we have?
Well, so Bob's not around. We believe that Bob probably has them since they're downstairs, and he manages those things because they're downstairs. But I will pull what we have for...
Or funding the subject to?
Any kind of plans for renovation or anything like that that relates to what's behind the walls in this part.
So, question for it. It was approved as a warrant article to spend money from CIP. In the event that you don't spend it, does it carry forward to be able to spend it at any time, or is it something that you have to do each year?
It expires at the end of the year unless you specifically carry it forward, if you remember. For 1 year. But you have to take action to vote to extend it for 1 year. And you can do that.
So you can encumber the funds for the year, or put it back into it.
I'm concerned only because, you know, one look at it, it doesn't give you one budget that it will let us that many more years. And if we don't have the money, if we put it back in the CIP, I would like it to stay in the boiler line and not be used for other things. So, you know, we just have to be cautious because...
It's 20 grand from CIP, 5,000 on the
taxation.
Yes.
So we could probably put more in for the remaining five or whatever, but that would be my only concern is that the money doesn't get spent on something else.
Yeah, I can't.
I would suggest that you encumber it because you can still choose not to do it next year.
For a year, for sure for a year, but if it gets beyond that, then, you know, I know that Yeah, but only can be used for that, right?
Yeah, that's what I was saying, is if we didn't really need it, we'd have to get it.
And then put it back in CIP?
Well, no, no, the 20 came from CIP, five is through taxation.
And the taxation money going to CIP for that?
No, because it's the purchase.
Okay.
And only for the purchase.
Okay.
But what can happen is if you did not want it in capital funds, then you could tell the state you're not going to do it, and that's a factor in the tax rate. If you're intent on capital funds, I would stay quiet with the state so that you still have the funds available to do the purchase if you choose to. So in other words, that $5,000 is affecting the tax rate. But if you choose not to do it, eventually it'll go to the general fund and it can be used to offset the tax rate or be in our fund balance, which is to be an off-the-ball.
It also doesn't speak to efficiency of boiler. Yeah.
Right, and so that was the other thing he said in that email, which is kind of a heavy conceptual idea, which is that later in the agenda, the Eversource proposal, he suggested not doing that, but instead looking at the HVAC system, the boiler, and all the systems, and combining them together into an efficiency program so that the whole thing could benefit, which again is conceptually a fantastic idea, but we don't have the right kind of staff to figure that out and manage it. So.
Well, nice that we've gotten his input, but you're right, it may last another 15, 20 years, whatever, or if that, I'm already done.
Right, and it's just going to happen now because we're consulting with them.
He says it's in great shape and, you know, he inspected it with that and it seems fine.
Well, Tom's like what, 2 or 3, right? 3 years? Isn't that about stuff?
Something like that.
Change, when it went from drop dive to like a couple of years.
A couple of years, yeah.
Yeah.
So I mean, we could do that, but, you know.
He also made a recommendation about the mall, should you decide eventually to purchase one?
Mm-hmm.
He has a recommendation about that.
The model.
Which model to purchase if you continue to do that.
All right, anything else for facilities director?
No.
And police consultants, my understanding that we have not heard back from either company yet?
No, and I've reached out to not the person I was speaking to, but the company for to say, I don't know why this person went off the radar and if there's anybody else who can help us, and so.
But I still think you would benefit from getting that information, really, but it's getting ridiculous at this point.
Well, I'm getting concerned that we could get them to, you know, compete, and then they won't do it for 5 or 6 months.
Right. Yes, the person I was corresponding with said July, August, September was the time to do it, and they would be available to do it at that time. So I'm hoping that means that she just went on vacation and will come back and be able to pick out running. I don't know.
It would be in time for 7 months now to get in touch with her.
Well, she's been 3 weeks completely off the radar. Before that, she was working on things and conversing. So.
She's still employed there?
I asked that question. I have not heard back yet, so.
Good question.
But yes, is she on vacation? Is she not employed there? Like, can you still manage it with somebody else?
Right, yeah.
So.
They put that on hold then for another night?
Yes.
So, all of our problems. Eversource proposal. So we have not received a contract from them yet?
There is no contract, but I did get an email that I didn't have time to read from, so the woman representing Eversource, one of the contractor, people have been on vacation. she apologized for the delay. I don't know, you know, so I'm hoping we have something. Yeah, so they're going to get streetlights to move this week, but as for other documents, not this week, but when we return next week. So I think it's just the nature of summer and everybody having to schedule a little longer.
Want to table it all? DMV printer, my understanding that town clerk is a new motor vehicle printer, although he wants one.
Yes, the one she's using is acting up and the state is no longer maintaining or replacing them. So she would like a purchase order approved so that she can.
Did she get a different price based on black and white versus color?
I don't know because I haven't spoken to her. I did find a purchase order in her file for you all, but it's not recorded to me because it's not. It's not ready to be signed off by at least.
$1,100. I sent her an email and asked her if it had to be a double tray, a double bin, or whatever, and that was yes. But I also asked her if it had to be color. She said no. So, you know, I know the ink is more expensive, but I think we at least need to go and look and see if there's a black, white versus color. There wasn't anything local, so we have to get it and have it shipped in. It's a 2-day shipment. So, and there was anything local color-wise, I don't know if there's anything local for black and white, but, you know, he said it was 2-day shipment, but I'd at least like to see, I said, at least like to see the black and white one. It
doesn't.
This is not budgeted.
Right.
You know, so.
This isn't the department one, what we use. This is the department one of vehicles.
Okay, now it's for a competition.
Right.
I agree with that.
Had provided the printer in the past.
And the maintenance, right?
Yes, and then, well, the state budget has changed over the years, and so.
Yes.
As it does. And this is one of the things that's going on with it.
And she told me the quality of the paper that the state now uses is what's making it jam. You know, so I guess she's had to roll those replaced a couple of times. It's the quality. They've downgraded on their paper quality because they don't have any responsibility anymore. So, you know.
Is she able to, this is for registration?
Yes.
Yeah, is she able to?
She prints, but it's printing. It's not like broken down, we have to do it right away.
She just wants everything in place so that when it does happen, if and when it happens this year, like she does not intend to buy it. That was my understanding last conversation I had with her, was that she did not intend to replace it until this one is put in the running. She just anticipated that might be
something. But she had some jamming, but that was also committed, you know, so that happens in every place that one doesn't work. You know, so I think she's been maybe a little while. So can you check with her to see if she can get time to do a black ink one instead of color?
Yes.
We also have a DMV printer. Right. D is Comcast annual extension. The long-term contract. So every so many years we have to review the dome. You have to look at the contract with our cable provider. Comcast is the biggest IT company that provides cable service as well. We have that approach to the network.
It is in the folder, isn't it? It's Comcast.
We have a 1-year extension for.
It's in the white folder. It's in that folder. You're in the right place, but in there, there's a white envelope.
Oh.
Yeah, it's in here. It's in
that
area.
This one.
Yeah. Okay. So, an extension for 1 year. We had asked, how long ago, maybe a year or so ago, maybe less, to have Steve Roberts review the actual contract that has been just extended. Every year, reauthorized, I'd like him to take a look at the actual contract. We have not got a response to that.
Okay,
send it to him, to the prior chair, and I think it just got lost in the shuffle in the office.
So, sorry, I didn't have to interrupt you. This is an extension of the original contract, which dates back to 1974. So the prior board just felt as though it was time to, rather than continue the 1971 contract, really work on language and evaluate the contract itself. So that's what Attorney Roberts was working on. But this here before you is just about, in the meantime, Comcast wants, you know, an official working relationship for the next year.
So does the contract dictate terms, raises, how often it raises, anything like that?
It's been a while since I've read it, and I found it really hard to read. The quality is really small, you know. I don't think it says.
It's a photocopy of a new draft.
I just, I don't know how these things work, like, do we vary it out to bid?
Well, so if you put it out to bid and you decide to go with another company, then every single person involved with that was Comcast, we have to change their people's service through whoever the person is, which, you know, I don't know what the options are for that, but you might want to have a public hearing.
If you're going to do that, we definitely want to.
Yeah. I would suggest doing a one-year extension of the contract, having Roberts take a look at it, and then we're going to follow up with him and make sure that,
You can do both at the same time. You can keep this going for one more year while you talk to Attorney Roberts about your goals and concerns with the contract itself.
I mean, yeah.
I say this as someone with no love loss for a company.
And if you,
Now that we're making their best.
If you search Comcast on the drive, you'll find the original.
It sounds like our current agreement comes to a fit.
I'm not sure that we ever signed the last annual one, frankly.
If this is from July 5th, no, that's 1972. The period of 12 a.m. on July 15th until midnight on July 14th, 2020. So July 5th is 1972 for the start of this. What's your pleasure?
Yeah, no, I think we should sign this.
I think you should sign it.
It would take a year to probably plan for
Before they've got to change one or the other.
And I agree with you, Mike, the new company is not going to be a company.
Well, you know, but the advantage of having Attorney Roberts take a look at the contract, there may be other things that the communities are getting, and the wrongs it's not getting, they can just extending for the 8-year-old contract.
Right.
Quick math on that, but I don't know how high it was.
Should we give it, should we sign for 6 months versus a year? Well, that's what it says, but we have to.
You can ask. We can send that back to him and say.
So we want to look and see to make sure that Comcast is
fine. You can even cross out that date.
Every other community is getting. But how do we find out where the other community around us is getting?
The list serve.
I'm sorry?
The list serve.
Oh, okay.
I think realistically, though, with everything else that we're kind of working on,
on the edge of the budget. So,
Alright, I'll make a motion that we accept the franchise agreement for 1 year with Comcast.
I'll second.
Move in second. Did all of the papers say aye?
Aye.
Opposed?
You have to sign it.
Oh, great.
The three of us have to sign it. But they haven't signed it, so.
No, they will sign it.
That's on the application.
Send it back.
So we should sign both sheets?
Yes.
Okay.
I you. Alrighty, then Comcast is taking care of for another year. Finally, check something out. Alright, recreation. That space is still on here. Does that need to stay on there?
No, I can give you an update. We are pleased to advise that the Legion has once again stepped up and is allowing us, for incoming weather for the last 2 weeks of programs, to use their facility free of charge.
Very nice.
They do believe more than people know that they do in this town.
Sure.
Somehow they need to be recognized, they're not sure how to do that, but they really do step up. They said it was all about the goods.
I think it would, the bare minimum what we should do is something off the app.
The banner.
The service, the email service, the thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Alright, can you send something out?
Yeah. What's that?
In the newsletter, if you can remember for that higher dollar, December now, but still, we should thank them for it.
But they just.
They do a lot.
They always step up. So, it's only during incoming weather, which is fine, because they still need to use the grade school as a facility, because we have the right to that, to one new room, the teacher room anyway, in a hallway. So, did that go in, is that here?
Mark has not, Mark's only got as far as talking to the woman from the services who wants the letter. He gave to me tonight the woman's contact information, she has a lot of questions beyond what he can answer.
So I thought it was only looking at the room.
Well, that was it, but now she's having conversations, she's wanting to know things about fun time, and we talked to her about fun time and where that is, and what exactly the rooms are that Rec is using, and she's getting confused between Rec and fun time.
So is it really us?
It is really us, it's just also fun time, and he needs help drawing a line in the sand for her about.
So I don't believe fun time is at the school.
I don't believe it at all in the summer either, but I can pass on contact information and talk about what's our program.
They have some program to pick kids out of department school, so they don't.
They never, but they don't have anything in the school. Yeah, yeah, they do something over there. Okay, so.
So it's getting taken care of, I'll talk to her. Okay, so, sorry, the fire chief received an email from someone at the State Department of Health and Human Services looking for a letter, I'm trying to let you write at the same time. Looking for a letter that sanctions the use of the space for that purpose, for that many kids.
Correct.
Because they handle capacity.
For licensing.
For licensing kids.
So I guess we should find out if we have to be licensed every year too, I mean.
I have lots of questions for her as well.
Okay, good. Well, just wondering what we can do.
Forty something years, you know.
I know, yeah.
We'll file your license.
Yeah.
If we need one, sure.
If we need one, yeah, okay, so we'll.
I will follow up tomorrow, and I'll let you know if there's any word to come with, but otherwise, Mark will write a letter, and I'll get a letter from the file.
Thank you.
Any other Rec updates?
Last week was supposed to be, because I don't say, you might not know more than I do.
First of all, we have the kids, what do you say?
I'm worried about staff, but.
Any staff bonus?
We only lost the ones that we were registered by the week, so we.
I was kidding, we lost a child.
No, but a couple of our towns, they don't start until after the 4th of July, so we were able to pull in kids from other communities.
So we didn't, we lost registration just for this week, it fell off.
Yes, because they were in their own communities, but it gave us a boost.
Gotcha, alright. Alright, anything else to say about Rec? We'll move on to building permits. Schedule of fees, Mr. Clark hasn't presented anything yet.
No, and that's not entirely his fault. I told him to hold off on that, I would give him
table, that's.
Yes. Yes.
Well, it's a problem. Policy review. Would folks like to review that?
No, we're going to table it.
I appreciate it.
It's been a long day.
Although, it would be really funny.
We do have to like step up sometimes.
If you made me sit there and review the policies that I will never be looking at, I won't be looking at or anything like that. Or have it, we're not, we're going to table it. Okay. All right, we've checked out one thing tonight. Town administration standing item. Board member activities and updates. Anyone have anything up there, son?
I didn't have anything last week.
Sure.
We went to recreation.
Oh, we went to rec, oh yeah, we did, we went to rec.
Just got it, just putting it all together and finding out what.
We just talked about.
Yeah, how we can help the director and assistant director and friends and ideas and stuff. And we're doing okay. It seems to be a little rough start, but just like, keep in mind that it's all in there and so we can learn there. And nobody knows anybody because we even went from Mollinsburg, so we have a little bit of.
This is what you said.
Yeah, yeah, but I think it's going to go well. We just need to. I'm going to keep us updated.
I had a historical committee meeting last week, but I also had a work session and that's not very standing, so I had to do that, so. But I know they have been working on park, wanting to do some updates, upgrades down to, and if you want to do that, I forgot to ask George in this year. Maybe for the next week to do that, asking about the electrical box.
I meant to email him, he said it too.
Okay, well, that's it, that's all. Rarely have any others in my mind. Over house for long. Alrighty then, town administrator update.
Okay, so it's been a busy week, a lot going on. I told you about a few of those things. One of them, I went to a welfare director's meeting last week, which was enormously helpful for our ongoing case. We don't have that tonight, but next week I'll update you about what I learned about that. I hosted a meeting with a representative from RICO. It was actually just an online meeting.
RICO?
RICO, the copier people.
Oh.
They're way more than.
I was thinking RICO statute, so.
No.
Really?
So I'm working on quantifying the time and costs involved in digitizing our information.
Okay.
And.
Plans and.
And when it comes to digitizing process at the same time. So I don't know costs yet, which will be expensive, but the digitizing process saves money. So it's another way, kind of like the LED goes on the bed. You say, you know, if you spend money, you can save money.
Right. In the long.
Well, it's a very, also like the electricity, it's a pretty short return on investment. However, you still, unlike Eversource, you do have to come up with the money ahead of time. My thought was to pick one process or one department at a time. The thing about it is, to pick a big department like planning and zoning is going to be expensive, there's a lot of paper. For the least amount of impact, because you don't have as many people experiencing the change.
Right.
And you want everybody to experience the change so they can see the value in it, and they can also give you feedback about how it could be better and how it could be applied to their departments. So it's really going to be a less expensive departmental function to say, like, a building permit process, which more people are involved in, that can, you know, be less expensive, but have a bigger impact in terms of informing the stakeholders about the benefit of digitization. So, not that paper's going away tomorrow, but it takes a lot of space, and it takes a lot more time to manage it than it does to manage digital documents.
Is that the savings aspect of management?
The savings is in the purchase of paper. The there's a brilliant slideshow, the presentation that I haven't shared with you yet. I will share it with you. It has a lot of anecdotal data about how much time it takes people to file documents and how it costs $25,000 to fill a cabinet. And you can fill out all the paper and the ink and the time to put it all where it goes. And how filing those same documents like mine did for you. So I will share that information with you. I just wanted to sort of plant the seed that I'm in an information gathering stage because I think this is one of the bigger things that the town needs to address in order to get more efficient, and ultimately it'll allow us to save money that we can direct to other things. So it's on my radar for a 1 to 5 year plan and how to get there.
One of my concerns about it only is that our systems aren't going to be strong enough for
cloud-based. And it will come with software that can manage it all and search it, which will be cloud-based.
I just, you know, we always seem to have a problem with our systems and our computers, and you know, we want to make sure that that's part of the equation when we go forward with the census to the town.
Yes.
That we need the resources as well to do it right.
Yes. And so, think about other concerns you might have or questions about what this will look like. I think ultimately I would like to have them come to a presentation with you if you have the public so that you can learn about the benefits and how they manage different aspects like security that could be a concern, you know, because they have answers for all.
And Commonwealth kind of have another tour, will be having a loop in that IT area.
So, I'm sure this is the only company doing this.
This is not the only company doing this. I spoke with the Kraken and Elta people who really didn't have any solutions for us. At first, they might be able to rent us a water scanner for us to use ourselves, but ultimately, no. So I'm looking for other companies as well. I know that RICO has done Lynn, Massachusetts, Amesbury, Mass, they did Allenstown. They've done a number of communities around. So they have experience with government. They kind of know where we're coming from, what our concerns and challenges are, and they can address it. Which is not to say another company can't. I think we absolutely ought to keep looking and make sure that we can costs, but it's the concept that I'm going for right now to see how can we get there. Ballpark figures for budgeting purposes, and then we can step back and get points for when we're ready to do that. So that happened today. It's a continuing conversation that I accept that they're going over to actually look at the scary rooms and the plans and files everywhere. And that's the next step before they get to us figures. They have to see what's our volume. So I'll keep you posted about that. I went to the Conservation Commission meeting last week. They are a really active, really, they're a fabulous dynamic group, and I'm really impressed with them. They're a wide range of voices being represented. And they're really trying to get active about conserving land and all, where there are a lot of big tracts that could go up for sale at any time. They want to get ready for that and strategize about how to get some of the new conservation that happens. And so they will likely be asking for a warrant article for a different amount of money to put into the fund that can be used to purchase such land. They'll talk to you when the time comes. I just want to plant that seed here if you're all thinking about it. They do also have an idea for working with the recreation, the parks and recreation people, and thinking about ideas for sand mix. So they'll be meeting the parks and recreation people in September to talk about that and see if they can work something out together.
I've been giving them from the ask for a volunteer.
They have to. I had a meeting last week with someone from the Census Bureau, 2020 Census year. Starting in August, people will be in the community randomly sending addresses for accuracy. They really want to engage with the town and with any other organizations we can think of, and I pointed her in some directions to work to help people know that the census is coming, make sure that they do it online as soon as possible. It will ultimately come into paper form if you don't apply online.
Yeah.
If you don't get to it, eventually someone will knock on your door. But of course they want to get the communities proactive about telling people about it and how some security things, they'll never ask you for your social security number and things like that, the scammers will. But it's really important because public funds are designated based on census data. So it's to the town's benefit that we can get as many people as possible to respond. And some of those people don't know to do that. The renters are an underrepresented group of respondents. Last year, the last time in 2010, 16% of Rollinsburg did not respond right away. And we don't know what the ultimate percentage was, but that many people required a knock on the door. So they would like us to try to get it.
Right. So I mean, is our apportionment for representation in Concord based on the census?
Yes.
So
and grant dollars.
Rollinsburg just had its own legislative membership on the other community. So find a few extra people.
Yeah,
so, and the whole host is why you're coming up.
So we'll do some public outreach, maybe email blast, and whatever we can do with the newsletter and whatever else we can do to try to get the word out to people to engage. And I'll talk to the library about maybe having them post a day when people can come here and use their computers and get help with the computer if they need it.
Signed up and post on the office, I'll do it.
Yeah. So, there's that. That's all.
I think we'll stormwater from our last time.
So the stormwater public hearing date is set last week. There will be a meeting stormwater committee before then. The date is workable. Thank you for that. It was discovered that it's in conflict with one of the CIP meetings, so we're going to move the CIP meeting date, and that's fine. But that's all for stormwater.
All right. Review of correspondence. What do we have in our folder tonight?
I don't. Okay, I have a purchase order 1645 Funtown/Town for rec for 9 admission tickets for a total of $351. And it says check to pay with.
Oh, credit card, CK.
Okay, CK to pay with credit card.
Oh, sorry.
Okay.
Purchase order number 1645 is going to move the second.
No.
All those in favor say aye.
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 The next one is purchase order 1649, New Hampshire Fisher Cats, 25 tickets to the New Hampshire Fisher Cats game on 717. With a total of $281.25.
So order 1649 has been moved and seconded. Any discussion?
This is the second half?
No, this is additional tickets.
Oh, additional tickets.
Any other questions? All those papers are added.
Aye. Purchase order 1648, Kennedy Lake Park, 10 admission tickets for a total of $390.
Second. Purchase order 1648, seconded. Any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Okay, I have
Thompson Energy, would like to thank you for your valuable business, of course, our fraternity, serving you for the upcoming year. They would like to offer the following prices to the town of Rollinsford. Propane with a fixed price of $1.999 per gallon, and two fuels at 18 cents over cost on the day of, delivery. On road diesel, it's 18 cents over our cost on the day of delivery. Service price is $1.25 per hour plus any parts used. The contract is between July 1st and May 31st of 2020. All deliveries are payable within 30 days. So is this, do you need help? Okay, so.
Typically, what we do, we usually hold that until we have a conversation with the school district.
We got the same.
They did get the same.
So they have the same price?
They got the same price.
Okay.
It's on their August agenda, so they haven't approved it yet, but the school doesn't see it.
So it's, is it so much over rack?
It's a separate rack, yeah. Within last.
They don't do over the road diesel, they don't do anything.
So last year was, $25.
$25.
Yeah, so it's gone down, actually. Good.
So, are we gonna table this?
We typically just make sure the school district can deal with that, because if not, then if they get a better deal with someone else, we want last round for that same deal. So I can't imagine there any better reason to come to the left, but some news is pretty good.
This is something to do with service.
We have in the past, yes. Towns have been consistent with the, better company. We did it.
We did it.
Maybe the second year, first and second year we did it, and then left the school district.
So the business administrator used to do it.
People suggest they bulk of drivers.
Because they agreed to do incentives.
Yep, yep. We wanna wait and see what the school does.
I don't think they're gonna withdraw this last year, right?
No.
I would wait, right. And I would be surprised if they didn't stick with the same company, but.
The other thing to keep in mind is, should you change companies, you would have to, switch out the propane tanks. Because prior and highway of propane and the new company would do propane.
They're not our thing, but they're kind of.
Right. Okay, so we're gonna defer that until,
I hate to pass the buck, but I would really wait.
Okay, so we just leave it like this, it's fine. So Mark left this, it's a purchase order 1617, Bergeron Protective Clothing for Globe GXCBL jacket for Deputy Chief Cook, $1,082.01. And he's putting it under protective clothing.
All right, purchase order 1617 has been moved and seconded. Is there any discussion?
This is a replacement or replacement for a customer we have?
Yeah.
They have a shelf life, which seems kind of ridiculous.
Great.
They have protective coating on it, I understand. They only last, you know, put them on it for long.
Well, he also is now, Deputy Chief, which was, I believe, the right code.
Oh, they have.
I don't know if it's going to happen before, I think they were like.
They tried to move clothing around as much as they could.
They do, but I mean, I don't know who was, that took this for.
So they did try to move.
But they always try to, but some stuff has to be recorded, so you're protected.
Any other discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
How many seats is that?
Is it one?
One cent.
One cent, they don't give us the one penny.
Arden's a tight head.
Here's the quote again. That is all I.
That it? For.
Nothing I can do there, right?
No, unfortunately, we're waiting. Four communities on this type of thing. Mr. Clark is in contact with the owner, he's gone over the inspection. We will be presenting him with a list of deficiencies in writing, my understanding. And we'll give him X amount of days to comply with those deficiencies, and then we'll be up to you all to decide whether or not to remove them, whether or not to remove or not.
Just to let you know, the last week, and another was, well, car is out, and then that was for the fire department to do training. So just to let you know that, because now they're gone, but they have their jobs, I think it was a jobs flight training. Well, previously, yeah.
Same thing.
Same thing, totally, I know. But anyway, that's.
Yeah, no, we appreciate of him lending his space, for sure. So, but. All right, so, we're going to agree the input, just so folks know, we have a non-public personnel issue we need to deal with. And then we'll adjourn and go home, we're not going to, we have to decide that, right? Any other community input? Yes, Sylvia.
So, what is the board's direction when they lose a member? When is the next step for the board? Do you advertise for a replacement like we did when we lost Suzanne?
Thank you.
And will it be you and decide what it would be for the next election time?
Any other community input? Nancy, sorry.
That's okay. Miles, I can't remember, is there another CIP coming in a couple of weeks?
The 11th.
Okay.
It's on the town calendar. There are three meetings coming. The August 7th one will get removed from the calendar, but there are two upcoming ones that are on the calendar.
Okay, thank you.
Girl, you want to say anything? Close it out?
I'll close it out after.
11th and the 25th.
Yeah, I had it in my calendar, and I'm going, I don't remember that. But thank you.
Thank you.
And thank you, Mike. Thank you, Mike.
Thank you. And I will send you a picture when we ever, if we ever get to any. Maybe get moved in Sunday. Boxes are there, but.
Yeah, I tried.
I had a year's worth of stuff at my mother's house that I need to pack up this week.
Have to consider
though
at your house, seriously.
Why not? I'll share it. So, and then you should run it off. So we hired, tried to find a moving company. Cheapest they ever found was $2,500. It seemed outrageous to me to load a storage. Everything's packed. They're not doing it. Put boxes on the truck, drive an hour, and unload the box. I thought that was crazy. Rented the truck from U-Haul. U-Haul then says on their website you can hire people to move it up to that will come and load it for the animal. So I did that. It was much cheaper than my house. And first set of people showed up, they loaded it up, they were very quick, very efficient. The next group showed up, they were actually there before because I got there with the truck. They were very efficient, started unloading them, they were very polite and uncalled to me. They said, where do you want the box in the kitchen? I said, put them on the floor here. Well, that's something I lost in translation. They took two boxes and they put them on the stove. And when they put them on the stove, they must have hit burner because Kate and I were in another room and Kate walked into the kitchen and said, oh my God, our kitchen's on fire. I had what? I used rather some textbook and came into the room. And so indeed there was two boxes, you know, good size boxes stacked up, flames shooting up through them.
Oh no.
From my room, okay, like a spark. So I used the new fire extinguisher that we used to use as a sort of a housekeeping joke here. Not so, but not so, but it was obviously a serious thing, but kind of a joke. But, and so it was that powder everywhere over the kitchen.
Oh my God.
Kitchen everywhere, you can use the got the fire, not out, I mean it was still smoldering. Threw it outside and sprayed it down with a hose. And then saw that there was still flames shooting out the burner. Because everything was all paper pressure, there was a bubble wrap. So bubble wrap had gone down into the stove.
Was it gas?
No, it was electric, thank goodness, because it blanket. She handed me the blanket, so I kept pounding on it. Why it's not coming out of this fleece blanket? It just kept melting. It didn't melt into the stove, it was melting and like shrinking. Like, why is the blanket getting small? I got it out. But yeah, so the stove was ruined. And home we go by the stove. That was a stretch. I'm gonna call them tomorrow. Yeah. The guy, to his credit, the owner called me that day. I don't mind what he told me. I guess I know it was an accident, probably wasn't intentional. But the wall was damaged, so I go, I'm too tired. I'll deal with you. I'll call you back in the next couple of days. So I will deal with that, I'm sure. They're gonna say, well, too bad. Not my own stove. Yeah. So welcome to the neighborhood.
Not just the stove, but whatever.
But it was also, yeah.
Yeah, there wasn't anything of real value. The house now reeks of smoke.
Yeah.
So
now we can really open up the rain.
And all day yesterday, I spent cleaning my cover up.
Yeah.
I also almost got to leave the hospital.
There you go.
Yeah, no, by the end of the week, hopefully everything will be packed up and